evening, everybody. We'll swatch it around. Welcome to another fifth concert of the year. We're very quite pleased to have Lucia and Sylvia and
Gerald.
Two names I can remember. It should be a wonderful concert, and I just remind everyone to please turn off or turn down your cell phones during the concert. Fermez vos cellulaires, s'il vous plaît. Et aussi, ne pas enregistrer le concert. Please don't photograph or film or record the concert, except for the official ones that are set up for the concert tonight. Also, there will be a brief reception after the concert. You're all invited to come back to your air hall afterwards for refreshments. Il y aura une petite réception après le concert. Tout le monde est bienvenu de venir et parler avec les artistes. Thank you very much. Enjoy the concert.
Thank you.
Vivaldi. He was an Italian composer of the 18th century, a priest, a teacher, and an extraordinary violinist, as you probably know from his very famous Four Seasons Violin Concertos. So, but in his time, he was famous as well all over Europe. His style was imitated and copied by many composers. Towards the end of his life, his style was going out of fashion a little bit, and he was looking for work. He came to Vienna, hoping to get a place in the court there. So this business of coming to Vienna was going to be become a standard thing in the 18th century, 19th century. All of the composers that are on the program tonight came to Vienna. None of them are from Vienna. But they came to Vienna to study, or to meet colleagues, or to make their name, or to find patrons, all of those things. Anyway, so Vivaldi came in 1740, he came in. It's possible that he crossed paths with Franz Josef Haydn, the next composer on the program. Haydn, il était d'une famille très pauvre, mais il avait une grande richesse, c'était sa voix. So he had this beautiful soprano voice, which earned him a spot in the boys' choir at the St. Stephen's Cathedral in Vienna. So that meant he could have free room and board, and most importantly, education. But he was 8 years old. He left his family and never really came back after 8 years old. So, and I think Jerry's going to tell you a little bit about the divertimento.
I'll gladly tell you about the divertimento. So, I grew up, and he moved to Vienna, and he got involved. He was lucky enough to be involved with the Esterházy family, which was an incredibly rich nobility within Austria. They were probably outside of Vienna because they had a huge palace and probably owned half of the country. Some say they were more wealthy than the emperor. Anyway, every one of these courts hired their sort of music director. They called him Kapellmeister. And he was lucky enough to be asked to be Kapellmeister for the Esterházy family. And while he was there, which was a tenure of about 30 years, he found that the Prince Nicholas of the Esterházy court played the baritone, which was a kind of stringed instrument. From the viol family, fretted, but very, very seldom heard, or there weren't many of them made. It wasn't typical like the viola da gamba or something like this. So there was nothing written for the baritone. Anyway, so part of his order from the Esterházys was to compose something for this prince to play on his instrument. I think there was over 120 trios written that involved this baritone viol. And so I'm sure after that, that was probably 1750, 1760 or something, one probably didn't hear any more of these works because these instruments were probably even more rare than an octobass, I don't know. But fast forward to the 20th century, around 1940, as celebrated cellist Gregor Piatigorsky found a collection of these. And from all of these movements, found three movements and rearranged them and adapted them for cello and piano, or cello and orchestra, it also exists. But anyway, and he called it divertimento. So this is a collection of works by Haydn, adapted by a modern cellist in the 20th century to play for you now. So it's a sort of hybrid between an early work and a more modern setting of it. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Three movements.
Thank you. play is a duo for violin and cello by Erwin Schulhoff. Schulhoff was a Jewish Czech composer in the 20th century who had a very interesting but very difficult life, which I won't get into now, but it's very interesting to read about, and you can ask me about it after the concert if you like. Schulhoff incorporated a lot of elements of expressionism and also native folk music from Czechoslovakia in his music. I'm sure you're going to hear a lot of components of that in this piece. I first heard this piece about 3 years ago, and I've been dying to play it ever since, so we're really happy to be able to play this for you tonight, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Schuhhoff, I think.